All right, guys, how is it going? It's the Eastbayanglers. We're out here. We're talking about Strawberry Lake. Strawberry Lake located in California. Not too far from Georgetown area. You know, this lake, I've known about it, fished it, been there, camped there 25 years. You know, it's been great. A lot of memories, a lot of good memories. You know, browns off the bank, bows off the bank, limits off the bank. I remember one time we caught, oh man, I can't remember how many rainbows, but you know, that was back in the early 90s, late 80s. I remember going there and it being like red hot. I don't remember in the last decade, 15 years, the lake being as productive. But having said that, neither is any other lake in California as productive. So, Strawberry Lake hosts a very good population of German browns as well as rainbow trout. And I am not sure if it has kokanee or not. I should know, but honestly, I'm not a huge kokanee guy. So, never really went there targeting kokanee. Never really went anywhere targeting kokanee. I just happened to catch kokanee as I'm going for trout, which is like a bonus. You know, actually, I caught like a 3.5 pound kokanee at Union Valley in 80 feet of water, which was like, what? Drifting in a float tube. But regardless, let's talk about Strawberry. You know, great little fishery, lots of rainbows. You guys go out there and you want to get on some fish. We're going to talk today about the top 5 baits and lures. If you're going out to Strawberry Lake, this is what you need to be fishing, guys. There's no excuse. You need to go out there, you know, and you need to have what you need to have. I'm going to break it down real simple. The first thing you're going to want to do is, if you have an option, you're going to want a kayak. You're going to want a boat, a trolling motor. Trolling is the most effective method on that lake. It's one of those lakes where you got to cover a lot of water. The fish seem to be spread out more so than a lot of other lakes. Not condensed as much, more spread out, these fish. And they require you to cover a lot of water to do well. Now, I can tell you that it is not always an easy fishery. But when you get on them, you're on them. And I want to also say that, you know, so we know trolling is, that's the method of choice. The real question is, what do you troll? And it's pretty simple. I really like to stick with basically, it's confusing. There's two ways I like to do it. I like to just sometimes tie a 1 ounce Castmaster out onto my line, or maybe a 1 ounce Panther Martin, and, you know, just straight to my main line and let it out. No flashers, no trollers, just the bare lure. Troll it. A lot of times I put that on one side and I go ahead and get some flashers and I put a lure or a night crawler 18 inches at the end of that. I'm going to, you know, come by, try to cover certain depths, change, if I don't get bit, change the depth a little bit, come back through an area. You should be able to cover an area in 30 minutes, get 3 different depths, 2 different presentations, and be able to know right away there's either fish here or there's not. But one of the more important things is you always start off when you're trolling 2 different lures, at least. You definitely do not want to go out there if you have 4 lines out with the same lure rigged up on all 4. your opportunity just goes down greatly.
All right, so it's pretty simple. You're going to rig a couple different options for trolling on, and you're going to get out there. You're going to cover water. You're going to change the depth that you're fishing at. General rule is spring and summer, high elevation, you can get away with top lining. As you get to that late summer period, you really need a downrigger. All right, guys. So number one method, troll. Troll, you know, the classic baits, you know, wedding rings, crocodiles, super dupers, cast masters, panther martins, needlefish, stuff like that. Maybe a worm. And if that doesn't work, your next option is to try and figure out where the fish are, get some bait, see if you can get those fish to take some artificial or even a live bait presentation if that's how desperate it is. But I would like to state that these fish don't really respond well to power bait. They don't respond well to power eggs or mice tails or any of that gibberish. They really do like a more natural, subtle profile. They like flies a lot. I mean, and it's amazing how many, you know, what hatches, what colors. It seems like, you know, flies can be king and then they can absolutely just, it can be dead. But they're definitely probably your best bet if you know where the fish are or you think you know where they are and you're trying to slow down and really get these fish. All right, guys, so let's say you troll a couple setups. You're like, nothing's happening. You go out there with a fly, you fish some productive areas, high percentage areas, nothing happens. What do you do now? Well, third option would without a doubt be any kind of spoon that you have confidence in that's red and gold. There's something about the red and gold combo that works really well there. But I usually will throw like a 5/8 all the way to a 1 ounce spoon, usually from the bank, and I'm able to cast it out, you know, it seems like half a mile, probably not though, and I can retrieve it at different speeds and keep it in the strike zone for a long time. And I really, to be honest, I catch a lot of fish. So I catch a lot of fish by chucking big spoons from the bank, you know, basically as far out as I can. You're going to chuck these big spoons out and you're going to modify them a little bit. You're going to change out the hooks, make sure the hooks are more appropriate size. Obviously the spoon being that big is to get a really large flash and attract fish from further away. Also, I can launch that thing 5 to 6 times further than I can a quarter ounce cast master or a quarter ounce spoon. And just that small modification, change the hooks out, you would be surprised. These rainbows will come up and they will slam that spoon. All right, guys. All right, it's pretty simple. I mean, it's trolling.
trying a few different setups, cover and water, locating the fish, slowing it down, high percentage areas, throwing a fly. If that don't work, go back to cover and water, big spoons, smaller hooks on those spoons. And usually, I don't have a problem. Those are the most effective ways to fish that lake. Now, let's say you're getting real desperate. Well, there's two things you can do. You can use preserved live bait, or you can use live bait. So, you know, if it's tough, you know, go to a night crawler, go to a wax worm, go to a red worm, go to a mealworm. If it gets really tough, like, I mean, it's harder than, it's the worst. Go to a cricket, find a cricket, lift up rocks in the area. Under those rocks is bound to be some bugs. That's about as good as it gets. Get those bugs, put them on the hook. They're going to have trouble staying on the hook. You're not going to have trouble getting bites anymore. Keeping them on the hook is going to be tough. Get some magic thread or some stretchy thread. Thread that stretches and does not break. That way, at least one part of the body you can kind of tie down. That way, when they bite it, they have to take the hook.